Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Jay Rich. Pseudonym. Real name is Jerome Doctor. Registered nurse, master of divinity, religion. I'd like to share a short video about the Social Security Trust question, birth certificate, trust question, and the multiple other trusts that people are saying that is under your birth certificate number or your name, as well as your Social Security name. One of the things I want you to know is back in the old day when they used to give out the silver, brown, or the metal brown Social Security card, it did have a account number on. You should be aware of that. And the main reason I'm doing this video, my background is in trading. I trade the foreign exchange market, and that is the movement of currency. Right now you're looking at the new Social Security card, which has a number, a letter, and a number on the back with numbers, and in the front, as you know, is your Social Security number. The thing that I'm disturbed about is the fact that people are sharing information, and this is the new birth certificate. This is, and remember, all of this sample stuff, this is not anybody's legal information. It is all sample. The thing that I am not pleased about, the information that's going out, this particular form is Fidelity. Go to Fidelity, open up a free account, and then put in the numbers like people are saying. Put in your social, put in the back number that's on your Social Security card without the letter. And right here it says $33 billion. Now the question is, what does this really mean? I would encourage you to do your homework. Text, chat, call Fidelity and ask them simple questions. Do not tell them what you believe you've seen. Ask them what they're seeing. The main reason I'm sharing this video is because my concern that people will do this with the possibility that the feds could arrest you. I am concerned about grandmas, mothers, sisters, sons, nephews, people doing this particular, what would you call it? Choice, or making the choice to use their social and their information to try to obtain monies or bills paid, and not recognizing that you have a possibility of being arrested. And if you don't know what you're talking about and have not done your homework, you could be sitting in a jail cell by yourself. Your local or your immediate family may come for a short time, but after a while, people have to go back to work, people have to go back to school, people have to do what they're doing. And when you're in jail too often, you are by yourself, if not your fellow co-prisoners. But the challenge is that if you're in prison because you use your social and information from your birth certificate in order to so-called pay bills, that you're not doing the homework that is required behind that. That if you're going to take a risk in your life, you need to do your due diligence and your homework. I will leave my phone number. I'm not looking to be on the phone call long periods of time with people. I'm going to be short to the point. Do your homework when it comes to anything. But the reason I'm doing this video is because I'm concerned that mothers and grandmamas and nephews and nieces will be going to jail. Peace.